now that I'm off to the Philippines. I need to check with Alfie's mother if she'll take him while I go and be with Kathleen.
Hello.
Hi.
Can we have a word?
Yeah, of course.
I really don't know how it's going to go down. Long story short, Kathleen's failed the English exam to come over to the UK, so I'm a little bit worried about her. I feel like I need to go over there to get her through the next few stages. Do you mind taking up some of the slack and looking after Alfie for that period of time? Me and Zoe are functional co-parents because we communicate about what we need to communicate, which is about our child.
Again? What do you think it is? Just drop and go? Just a classic Richard card game. And obviously he's going over there to support Kath, but he's also got to remember that he has got a son at home who still needs to be cared for. I'm sure just... you planned this because it's half term again.
Is it half term?
Yeah.
Oh.
And he's off for 2.5 weeks this time.
Is he?
Yeah.
Wounded.
And you're off again.
Swanning off.
How are things with Kathleen? Anyway, what is the plan going forward?
So I'm hoping to get her over on a work visa, which is great for me, because we don't have to just jump straight into marriage. So it's a try before you buy option.
Rick doesn't think about things he says. Alfie's the same. Sometimes they say stuff where we'd want to crawl under a stone.
We're in constant communication. That bit's great. It's just all the physical stuff, and I've got to do my own washing, and I've got to do all the cooking and the cleaning.
I think when Kathleen comes, she'll be in for a shock with Richard and his home life. And Richard has always had a wondering eye, and I think that'll obviously be one of the things that she'll obviously have that bit of insecurity about.
And then once she's over here, it's great. I'll have him more, and you can, you know, go away on holiday.
Well, he'll have a mum, won't he, and not just a playful dad who doesn't keep him on the straight and narrow. Richard will want his tea on the table, his clothes folded, smelling really nice every day. I don't think in reality that's the way the world works.
Me and Kathleen are getting a couple's tattoo. We think it's really cute.
Hi, good afternoon.
And it's just gonna be significant in our relationship.
We have our own design. It's a camel with a crown of king and queen.
Where is the placement of the design?
That will be on our toes.
In your toes?
The tattoo is just something that we wanted to do as a couple together to make our relationship, I think, a little bit stronger.
Is it in the big toe?
Big toe,
big
yes.
Actually, it's unique because it's a camel tattoo. In UK, they have the meaning, but I don't mind because I find it sweet, I find it funny and cute.
We'll just have to, like, do some sizing on it.
Yes.
Yes. Because yes. I might have a bigger toe than you say.
Yeah, obviously. Yeah.
It's a bonding experience. It'll bring us closer together. When I go away again, every time I look at my toe, it will remind me of my amazing adventure with Kathleen.
Well, let's take my weight.
Can that get...
Yes, this is you.
Can it?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Oh, let's get it on.
Get it on, baby.
Ow.
Baby.
Yeah.
Is it hurting?
It hurts.
It's like an annoying little thing.
Having the queen and the king crown, it makes it romantic. And we're having this one forever.
Obviously. It doesn't come off when it's on, does it?
Silly,
you look great.
Matching tattoos. That means that we're going to be together forever. I don't want anybody else. I like to look, but I'm not going to touch.
It will be forever. It's stuck forever.
I think it just secures our relationship. It makes us stronger.
Is it too late to get matching jewellery instead? It's hurting.
Can you take us a photo together? Do like that.
No, they're gonna kiss me.
No, don't. Baby, it hurts.
I'm kissing!
It hurts.
I got a bigger camel than you got.
Oh my God, look at my toes. Maybe I should have got a pedicure before I came here today.
Mine too.
Oh, sexy feet. Wow.
Now we have our couple tattoo. Richard should not do stupid things anymore like before, like cheating or whatever.
When Kathleen comes to the UK, she's gonna treat me like a king. King Richard. I'm a very busy boy, I'm out all day. It'd be my ideal scenario that Kathleen would do everything around the house. I'm off to meet my friends, Gavin, Jenny, and Stuart. We're gonna get drunk, I'm gonna tell them all about Kathleen. Yo, yo, yo. Hello, you all right? Got the drinks in? Fantastic.
All right, so why have you brought us out here, Rich? What's up?
Do you know that I've been dating this Filipino girl, Kathleen, for a long time now? And finally, I'm getting my chance to bring her over here.
Oh, wicked.
Well, I'm not even bringing her over here. She's bringing herself over here.
Right, okay.
I just get all the benefits, and she's doing all the hard work.
So what does Richard define as benefits, then?
She's going to cook for me, she's going to clean for me. I get to wake up in the morning next to her. She's coming over here to work for the health service.
So she's coming here, we're going to be working 70, 80 hours a week. And you're not?
Yeah.
But she's going to do the cleaning, cooking, everything around the house as well.
Yeah.
I wouldn't do it.
She's changing culture.
No, work 40 hours a week and then have to cook and clean and wipe your backside, no? Not expected to come over and be everything you want.
But she wants to be that, though. She wants to look after me. She wants to do those things. It's not me.
You don't need looking after.
Of course I need looking after. I'm a man child.
Fully grown man.
It's literally built into many, many people that's the job that they're gonna do. And they do it without question, without asking.
But you pray on that, though, as well, though, don't you?
I like that. She's gonna be the rock that's gonna hold me up so I can go off and be fabulous, and I can go and work really, really hard.
She's got to work out.
The house is relatively clean, so it shouldn't be that difficult to keep on top of it.
She's coming here to improve her life.
She's coming here to be with me.
Well, I just don't feel that what you're saying is necessarily going to be an improvement for her.
Why? Because if she's got an issue with it, she needs to open her mouth and say something. I'm not forcing her to do anything, and I'm not going to tell her to do anything. She's going to do it off her own back. And if that's a problem for everybody else, it's your problem. You need to deal with it. Because, you know, you're speaking up for this girl, and that's great, but let her have the voice. Let her come to the table. Let her say, actually, it doesn't matter. And then, at that point, we stop breaking my balls.
OK.
Do you know what I mean? She's got equality. She's not a lower human being than me. She is my equal. And we are a team. She's amazing. You're going to love her. I'm going to love her. I already do love her. Probably should have said that first. Boy, have I got some news for you. So the Philippines went fantastic. I was doing everything that I could to make her family like me and understand how Kathleen lives, to kind of strengthen our bond and strengthen our relationship. However, since I've come back, Kathleen's been a little bit distant with me, a little bit off.
That's weird.
She's talking about that she has fallen out of love with me.
Wow.
When she is talking to me, but most of the time, she's not returning my messages or calls. The only thing I can think of is that perhaps, you know, it's her time of the month.
Oh, all right, OK. So do you think maybe, obviously, because knowing you, you've been out there, and while you're out there, you've been Richard, you know, do my cleaning, do my cooking, and she's now thinking, now that she's had this time with you, that maybe it's, well, no, this isn't what I want. I'm just trying to help you. And, you know, and obviously...
It's not helping me.
No,
it's more,
I mean,
antagonizing me.
Yeah,
it's not
giving you other ideas, Richard.
But I do not take any responsibility for this at all. I think that I've gone above and beyond what an average boyfriend would have done to make this relationship work.